He had long green moss growing on his back, and it waved in the water when it swam. He had notches all along from his head to his tail where the motor of a boat dug in. He had a half a dozen hooks hanging from his lips, all rusted, busted, and bent. He had one big bloodshot eye on the right and on the left side, nothing but a dent. Now, I'm a pretty good fisherman, but plain old Joe, he's great. He knows all there is to know about boats and bass and bait. Well, he'll catch more on just one cast than most men catch all day. To Plano Joe, there ain't no such thing as the one that got away. Now, Plano Joe's from Texas, where everything comes big, where the bastards mean as rattlesnakes and outweigh most any pig. You can't catch a smallmouth if it's largemouth bait to use, 'cause them bass, they ain't just big and mean, but they all got high IQs. Now, up in Lake Texoma, there lives a striper. His name is Jake. And everyone down in Texas knows that's the biggest fish in the lake. He'd never been caught, but he'd been seen by all the local pros, swimming round the bass boats, thumbing his big bass nose. He had long green moss growing on his back, and it raved in the water when it swam. Notches all along from his head to his tail, where the motor of a boat dug in. Had a half a dozen hooks hanging from his lips, all rusted and busted and bent. One big bloodshot eye on the right and on the left side, nothing but a dent. Well, Plano Joe was on the lake around sunrise, 6th of June. In his box he had just one lure, a spinner with a silver spoon. He had just one rod and just one reel and just one great big lake. Today's the day, I heard him say, I'm gonna boat that fish named Jake. He cruised out Ross's Cove, headed down lake to the dam. Just beyond old Walker's Point, he said, Jake, here I am. He shut that outboard motor down, took out that silver lure, tied it to some heavy line, and he cast out strong and sure. Now, I've known Joe for 40 years, maybe even more. But when that fish hit, his blue eyes lit like I'd never seen before. That line went tight and that pole went thin and that drag began to spin. There was smoke rolling out the back of his reel when his line jerked to an end. Then the fish began to tow the boat so fast it left a wake. Joe said, I'm gonna beat this bass if my back and my line don't break. And as he zoomed off across the lake, he said, you can tell my wife I've been home every night for 29 years, but I won't be home tonight. Well, after 40 days of fighting, that fish could barely swim. At 20 more days of playing tug of war, Joe started reeling in. After 10 more days of reeling, Joe was eye to eye with Jake. He said, tell me now, you water sow, who's the baddest in this lake? Then Jake spit out that silver lure right back into old Joe's face. Started dancing on his tail like a theme park wheel, splashing water all over the place. Well, Joe ripped off his hat and his shoes and he said, hooks be damned! Forget that rod, forget that reel, I'm gonna get this fish by hand. With that, old Joe jumped in the lake and he swam out to that fish. He grabbed his tail, but Jake shook loose with one big mighty swish. Then Jake grabbed Joe by his sleeve and drug him down below. The water did boil and bubble and blither, didn't see him for an hour or so. Then up they shot like a water spout, about 100 feet in the air. They were flipping and spinning and flapping, slapping, and scales flying every which way. They thrashed and they splashed till the sun started setting, and when the water finally stills, here comes old Joe swimming lifeguard style, hauling Jake in by the gills. And he was singing to him. You got long green moss growing on your back, and it waves in the water when you swim. Notches all along from your head to your tail, where the motor of a boat dug in. You got hooks in your lips and a bloodshot eye, but hey Jake, it wasn't your day. 'Cause to Plano Joe, there ain't no such thing as the one that got away.